Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Bills' offense now, they get set to head back onto the field. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points. Nowhere to get away, and down he goes. Tanner is sacked. Cassius Marsh. Tough to handle on that blitz. He gets him for a loss of five. Third and long. Taylor and company hoping to regroup after the sack. From the shotgun, it's Taylor. Under pressure again, and down he goes again.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Schmidt on to punt as he sends it away. That's taken on the 25. Oh, some strong running. He had one man to beat. It takes a touchdown saving tackle to bring him down. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. Down. He's going to wind up and air it out. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively.
Come on, let's go.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Wide open receiver complete. And they do get him down, but not before he reaches the 4-yard line. A good pick up there, 26 yards. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown.
I know a lot of people look at these games and think, all right, this thing's done. Let's have some sportsmanship. Let's not try and score. You should never do that in the NFL. I've seen big leads blown, and teams that looked like they had a victory, all of a sudden were going home with a loss.
Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. The Bills getting set to go. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Now Taylor to throw on second down. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And it'll be third and 10 now.
Here we go.
Off the play fake. Here's Taylor going up top. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
And attempted a deep ball there. They didn't get it. But, boy, they're going to need a few of those to actually hit in order to get back into this game.
Good thing they do have a little bit of time here still left in the contest. Decent-sized deficit, but not one that they can't manage. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Taken in at the 22. So possession goes over here on the punt. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a first and 10.
Here we go. Right at 38.
They'll run it now out of the gun. Showed the nice footwork and then hit and drop shy of the 45. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
Come on, let's go.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. The ball still a few inches shy of the marker after the 3-yard run, so now a little soul searching on fourth down. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. Give him 3 on the play, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches. So the offense has it first and 10. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
And now here's a carry heading left. And he's across the chalk into the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks. A great play there. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Seahawks add on to their lead. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. On the return, it's Brandon Tate. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And here come the Bills. Typically down in the first half, I might say, oh, you at least need a field goal out of this drive. But they're down to the point where they need a touchdown, don't they?
Yeah, and normally you know me. I mean, you've been around me for a while now, right?
Unfortunately.
I'm sorry about that. But normally I'm the one preaching patience.
Yeah.
You know, take your time. First half, you still got a chance. I think they're out of patience here. This has to be a drive that gets a touchdown. So if you're the play caller, you're going to that portion of the sheet that says big time plays, specials, anything you can use to get yourself back into it. I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence, haven't allowed a point yet, flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
And an incomplete pass. That'll stop the clock here with just under a minute to play in half number one.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
And he will lose yardage on the play back at his own 19-yard line. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. And the punt team on now as this one sent away. And he fields it cleanly. Right through it.
Boom, bam, biff.
Excellent work on the run back there. 33 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Seahawks offense now, they get set to go back to work. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now. And that's why they've opened up this big lead.
You know, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? But everything is working for them. Every move they make works. It clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. Now a handoff here to his running back.
And all the way in, touchdown, Seattle. A great effort there with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Seahawks are running away with this one.
Heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full authority to go ahead and bring it out and try to be aggressive. Almost what we call the green light, red light theory. Green light means go, red light means stop. Looks like he had green on that play.
Let's go!
They'll start the drive with a carry by McCoy. And a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going. And really, the offensive line not helping him much. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning... into quite a rout as we send you now to Orlando and our Tiburon studios where Larry Ridley's standing by with our EA Sports halftime report. Larry, this fielded a few yards into the end zone. Able to slither by. And some room to roam now. He's got daylight. And he's going to score. It's a Seahawk touchdown. And people still trying to get back to their seats from the concession stand here at the start of the third quarter. And boom, we got points on the board.
And you just identified why the bulk of stadiums have increased presence in the concession areas, right? TVs, loudspeakers, so people can still follow the game. And right now, they're bummed out that they missed that big return to start this half.
So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. That's fielded in the end zone. And he probably should have stayed in the end zone as he'll muster a return up to only the 14-yard line.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover. They want to try and put points on the board.
Now McCoy, and a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I'd say they've got to find a way to get him going. He's such a big part of their offense. I wonder if they might throw it a little and come back to the run.
Anything, because you're right, he's pretty much been completely neutralized. Now it's Taylor. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. The intended receiver was Corey Brown. Third down here.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
Taylor to throw on third down. And the Seahawks defense gets to him, and they bring him down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. fielded at the 33. Oh, he knocks him over. It looked like he might beat that last man. He doesn't, though, but it goes as a 32-yard return. And out will come the offense as they take over. And a great spot to start this drive from here. They'll look to throw here on first down. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. And he comes back with one complete. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Let's go!
They'll look to throw now on first down. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked a ball off yet. That probably should have been their first. And it's third down now.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
They'll set up a throw. Flush to his right. He can run for it, and he will. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Here we go.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Flushed out right. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw, eluding the pressure right. And he's going to score. It's a Seahawk touchdown. It's their quarterback, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Seahawks offense continues to pour it on. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because... He's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. Here's Walter Powell on the return. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Here's the Buffalo offense now as they get set to take over here. These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk. Come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try to figure out what is working, and call more of that.
And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, 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 and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Again, it's McCoy. And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. No gain that time, and it leaves him with third and 11 coming up. So nothing there, but maybe you blame that on the blocking.
Yeah, at some point, you've got to win at the point of attack. And on that play, that was all the defense. They made it happen.
And that would not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. Here's Colton Schmidt now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this will be taken at the 13. Nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And it'll be Seahawk football, first and 10. The Seattle now ready to march onto the field. And Charles, in a very one-sided affair, I think we've reached the point in the broadcast where you and I, we may have some filling to do, right?
Yeah, I think you're right about that, because we got to try to keep people around. We don't want them to change the channel. Stay with us in this game. Is that Ben Ramsar? Are you hearing from Ben on the headset here? Tell us.
Stretch.
Stretch out a little bit.
Get some talking points. Dig them all out.
That's what you get. A big-time producer. Keep them here.
Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
Now, those are the ones that hurt defensively. You do everything right. Excellent pressure, good coverage downfield, and then he slips out the back door and turns it into a nice gain.
Here we go.
Back to throw now on first down. Escaping the pressure right.
Whoosh.
The 20. And then he goes with, and he's going to score. It's a Seahawk touchdown. Their quarterback, 41 yards. And the Seahawks are running away with this one.
Well, this game is definitely over, but we do know some people like to go ahead and continue to add to their score, don't we?
Yeah, I don't know that they need to add any more right now, though. I'm just starting to think about those dinner plans tonight, my friend.
Well, you and I will be thinking about dinner plans, but we also know that playing people are thinking, how can I get some more scores for my fantasy, forever other things? They're trying to figure that part out now.
By the way, last weekend we went sushi because that's what you wanted. We're going steak tonight.
I'm in.
All right. Extra point try now for Walsh. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was, as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. The Bills' offense coming out, ready to take over. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep him
warm. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
My man, it's been a rough night for that offensive line, and it's only getting rougher. 5 sacks now that they've given up in this contest so far. It feels like the witching hour out here, doesn't it?
Okay, stupid question. What's the witching hour?
Yeah, the witching hour. That's when everything goes haywire late at night.
McCoy. And not much there as he gets it up to about the 5-yard line. They get 2 yards back, but they're going to need a lot more than that here on third down. And the trend continues here in the fourth like it was in the first, second, and third. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs. But bottom line is, he takes care of the ball well for them, so they'll keep handing it to him.
Here's Taylor. And Taylor cannot escape. He goes down to the end zone. Things are just going from bad to worse now. It's a safety that does him in here, and that is one frustrated offensive unit.
They can't get out from under their own shadow right now. I mean, I know this is the NFL, but could you imagine a college crowd right now? Imagine what they'd be doing. They'd be chanting, start the bus, because they think this one is over.
Looking to throw. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Jerry Hughes coming hard that time. He's able to run him down for a loss of 12. Back to throw here. Rolling to his right. And some space here. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be a third and about 13. They'll look to throw. Being chased out left. He may try and run for this. So no sack. He gets back to the line of scrimmage, but it'll still bring up a fourth down.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage. No gain.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. They'll drop the throw. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And that's caught inside the 30. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Walsh now for the PAT. Now, this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Here's Walsh now to kick this one off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And now out come the Bills. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
Let's see how they handle the waning moments of this one. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Brown. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. A gain of 6 there on first.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position, because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
And the connection not there. Incomplete. Just 14 seconds down to the final couple of plays here. It's been that kind of a day so far throwing the football. It just seems like nothing going right offensively.
Yeah, it's a catch that should have been made, pure and simple. And look, everything else that goes into running a good pass route, throw it all out if you don't catch it.
Looking for Watkins, and it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, They've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Really nice starting field position here for the offensive unit. He'll drop to throw. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charlie, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you can put yourself in jeopardy.
And this will be caught. Well, forget taking the knee. Some late gamesmanship here as they throw for a late touchdown.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. I mean, he's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone. This guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
Four touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone.
The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt the number zero, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is, and what an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. How about that zero on the scoreboard for them, going along with those zeros in the time column, too?
So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. From South Florida, good night, everybody.
Trying to say I'm only enemy. Got a cold with my dogs, can't get in.